road. Oh, great. Looks like California is thinking about yet another gun control bill. This time they want to actually ban detachable magazines. They want to make people register. People who buy and sell ammunition register their ammo. Are you serious? I got to go through a registry just to pick up ammo? It's bad enough that it's getting really expensive, but now I got to register this. Oh. Gotta be careful, but anyway, California is just getting completely insane. The Zimmerman case, George Zimmerman, that neighborhood watch guy who shot the 17-year-old Trayvon Martin, that guy. Well, that guy is dealing with a murder trial, second-degree murder trial, and his defense recently got a win when they were able to throw out possible testimony of audio analysis expert. This person was going to testify that whoever was in that 911 tape yelling help couldn't have been George Zimmerman. That's pretty huge. Although his case didn't really help itself when his attorney got up there and opened up the trial with a knock knock joke, which I just did. I didn't think it played well at all. It didn't play well with anybody in the place. I don't think it could have played well with the jury at all. Whatever strategy he had in mind, it was not going to work. It was not going to work. Okay. Well, at least opening an argument. So I don't think his case is screwed entirely, but just, I think it was just a bad call overall. Okay, Brazil. Massive protests in Brazil. They had what? 80 cities, protests, a million people in 80 cities. I mean, that's incredible, in 80 cities in Brazil. The protests were so rough that a person actually died, an 18-year-old kid actually died in a protest. Pretty incredible, but it shows that, a lot of people are fed up with the services, they're fed up with the police corruption, the system corruption, they don't like it. So people are starting to verbalize, they're starting to show, they're starting to protest. They're showing their contempt for the system. Okay. Okay. In France, they're now saying that their economy is going to actually contract. Am I supposed to stop here or what? No. Okay. It's a little bizarre. Pay attention. Yeah. Their first quarter, they actually had a contraction of 0.2% their GDP, but in the second quarter, it actually grew 0.2%. But overall, in the 2013, they think France is going to have a contraction. France is in trouble in general. The Eurozone is going through it in general. They're going through it right now. So that's not a surprise at all for me that the Eurozone, that they're going to have some contraction, because I think they're in a recession. They're contracting. Okay, antidepressants. According to Professor Stephen Pillings, this guy is an expert, and he works for the National Institute of Health. This is out there, of course, in the UK. This guy has recently come out and said that, you know what, if you're on antidepressants and you're a pregnant woman, the chances of that kid having a heart defect doubles, which is absolutely incredible, if that's actually true. Of course, the manufacturers have countered that, but it's something worth paying attention to. So he said if you have mild to moderate depression, it's probably not worth the risk. So, I mean, what would you do if you were presented with that situation and you had severe depression or you had moderate depression? I mean, would you risk the baby's health? Do you think it is a risk? You got to think about your own health as well. Because if you don't, then, that too is also a threat to the baby's health. Okay, 80% of Americans. Not 80% of Americans, but 80% of the food, the prepackaged food in this country, is pretty much banned elsewhere. I mean, you can't use this. You can't even sell this in other countries. That says a lot, that other countries will say, you know what? You can't sell that here. But like 80% of our food, and this olestra, which is used in a lot of low-fat or type of foods, that's something. Apparently, there's a serious risk of gastrointestinal issues. It's a potential to have some issues there. So, it's pretty interesting. 76% of Americans, 70% of, 76% of Americans are living paycheck to paycheck. That doesn't surprise me one bit. Not one bit. You know, most of these people don't have enough money. They don't have enough money to actually get by with on 6 months. They don't have enough money put aside for them to go by on 6 months if they lose their job or whatever income they have. That's how serious the situation is. Something to think about. And I recently I've been trying to buy some ammunition, but I haven't been shooting as much as I used to. You know, the price of ammunition, the price of guns, you know, now I think they went way too far with the prices of guns. I'm going into gun shops and I'm seeing Walser 10s for $1,000, over $1,000. Just recently, I was stunned. $1,000, $1,100 for a Walser 10. Think about that for a second. I bought mines for what? $400 in 2010 or 2011? And now they're trying to sell those damn things for what? For what? You gotta be out of your mind. You gotta be out of your mind. And ammunition is hard for a lot of people to find. You can't find 9mm anymore. 9mm, no way. Can't find it anymore. 40, difficult to find. It's just nuts. You know? This is completely insane. But, you know, I think it's going to blow up in the gun industry's face. Because what's going to happen is people are going to get used to not shooting as much. And they're going to find other things to do with their time because it's just not that affordable. Because, you know, you go out to the range, you're like, bang, $1, bang, $2, bang, $3. I mean, who in the hell can afford to do that on a regular basis? The average American can't. I mean, not when 76% of them are living paycheck to paycheck. It's something you got to think about. So, anyway, that's what I've been looking at, thinking about for today. Am I still prepping? Hell yeah! I want to warn people, you definitely got to make sure you have some water. Make sure you have plenty of extra water. That's absolutely critical. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for today.
Bye.